Hey everyone, Grant K for the Flame Learning channel. In this video, you'll learn how to use the RAM player functionality in Flame 2017 Extension 1. The purpose of the RAM player is to give you a massive performance enhancement when your system's configuration may not be up to the task. For example, if you are pulling 4K media from slow storage or a remote storage connection, there may be a chance that you cannot sustain the performance for playback. So the RAM player allows you to cache a range of frames into memory in order to improve the playback. This video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. Now the RAM player will be accessible in every area where you encounter a player. This includes the standard player, the full screen player, the player in batch, and the full screen player in the media hub. Wherever you are, the controls will always work the same way. Now let's look at the workflow. Here I have an open sequence in the timeline area. In the player toolbar, you will find the button to enable the RAM player. When the RAM player is activated, you will get in and out markers, which can span the length of the clip or sequence. You can adjust the markers to define the starting point, as well as the end point for the RAM player. If you don't have enough RAM, or the clip is very long, the markers will give you the maximum range that can be cached into memory. If you try to drag a marker beyond the maximum caching range, the caching range will shift to ensure you can't cache more RAM than what you actually have on your system. Please note the handy indicators when you move each marker to identify the specific start and end frames. Once your range is set, you press play. The frames will be cached first, and once this is completed, playback will begin. You can also use the RAM cache in combination with the play modes. Click and hold down the play button. You can play once, you can loop the playback, or you could play the range forward and backward. Choose to loop the playback. Pressing play will loop the clip until you stop playback. If you want to change the caching range, you could move individual markers, or you could hold shift and drag to a new area of the clip or sequence. This will keep the duration of the caching range, but allows you to see other portions of the clip or sequence. Now you need to be aware that making any adjustments or even moving away from the player view will flush the RAM cache. Just press play again, and the RAM player will cache the frames in the defined range. So this performance enhancement will definitely help when struggling with storage. Now there are a few details you need to be aware of. Firstly, there are a few options unavailable when you use the RAM player. 2-3 insertions, the compare mode with split players, and the hide effects options are not available. To use any of that functionality, you must disable the RAM player by turning off the button. Secondly, the editorial in and out marks do not define the RAM player range. You must use the markers under the player to set the caching region for the RAM player. Thirdly, the purpose of the RAM player is caching for performance enhancement. The cached media is intended as a preview. Therefore, you cannot process out the cache as a rendered clip. However, what is definitely good to know is that the RAM player uses the proxy settings when performing a RAM cache. So it will cache a full resolution version or a proxy version of the media if proxies are enabled. The RAM player is definitely a great performance enhancing tool to have, especially if your drive performances are not up to scratch. Be sure to check out the other features, workflows, and updates to the Flame 2017 Extension 1 products. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching. And please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.